A little baddie, she my little boo thing,
and she makes me happy.
Hey, what up you guys, it's Barcode Batty, and I'm back with another awesome GTA 5 glitch. This is going to be the Carter Car Auto Shop Merge glitch, and it's super easy, so let's get right on into it. First and foremost, you want to go ahead and spawn inside of your auto shop, and then what you're going to want to do is go ahead and exit the auto shop. So once we exit, I am in a invite-only free aim lobby, so I can teleport. So what you want to do is once you're outside, you're going to go ahead and make sure that all the jobs are showing on the map if you're in a free aim lobby, because most friends will be playing an assisted aim, and you want to job teleport to your bunker. So as you can see, I find the job that's closest to my bunker. I go ahead and start that job up. I find a friend that's in assisted targeting mode, and I join their session. And then I'm just going to accept the first alert, and I'm going to decline the second. So then I can go ahead and be right down the street from my bunker. As soon as I get to my bunker, I'm just going to enter and then exit. See you. Now that I've exited my bunker after just walking in, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing and job teleport back to my auto shop. So I'll see you when we're there. Now, once you're inside your auto shop, you want to go ahead and get inside the donor car, which is this is the car that you want to go ahead and take the mods from and transfer onto the car you want to put the mods on. So, excuse me, sorry. So I'm just going to go ahead and mod this Dominator right here. I'm going to change one thing on this Dominator, which I'm going to change it to the crew color so it's still unselected. And then after that, I'm just going to simply back out. So once you change one thing, just go ahead and exit the auto shop area. Just like that. And then you're going to get out of the vehicle and you're going to go ahead and call up Simeon, Gerald, or Martin, and you're going to request a job from them. So go ahead and pull up your phone and do that. As you can see, I've already got a job here from Gerald, I'm pretty sure, but I'm going to call to request a new one. So once you request the job from Gerald, you want to walk up to the car. As you can see, we have the new option of buying the car. So with this auto shop merge, it does kind of suck because you do have to spend money. But at the same time, it's totally worth it because you still get a modded vehicle out of it. So what you're going to do is walk up. Once you get the job alert, you're going to click X on the job, accept the job, load into the job. And then when you back out of the job, you go ahead and spam right on the D-pad right here. And as you can see, the mods did transfer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk up to it. I'm going to press square to purchase the vehicle. And then you want to go ahead and put it inside of the auto shop and put it over an LG, a free vehicle that's inside of the shop, which will make it to where you did spend the money, but you didn't spend the money because it just went over a vehicle you're already replacing. So as you can see, it's not here yet. You want to go to vehicles, make sure that you return personal vehicle to storage, but as you can see, it's going to appear here shortly. I'll get the alert. So I took the mods from this car here and I put them on that car in the service garage. Let's see here. It's going to show up here. There it is. Perfect. So as you can see, the car is here. I can get inside of it and I can drive it outside. So, as you can see, I'm outside, I'm in the car, I can drive it, it's mine to have and to hold for all of eternity. Thanks for watching. If this merge worked for you, please like and subscribe, as always. Until next time, you guys, keep it real.